Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to more Delta Force. In today's episode, we are going to be covering this mission called Headhunter. Now, this seems to be the final mission in the Peru chapter, and yeah, I mean, if this gets over, Peru is over with, you know, like, if this is indeed the final mission, then Peru is over with just 6 missions. But I suppose either A, you'll be unable to capture the drug lord and you'll have to go in to finish the task in the subsequent mission, or maybe they'll balance it out by adding another mission in one of the other 4 campaigns here, since I was promised 40 missions in this game, but, or maybe that was Delta Force 2, I forget. Anyhow, moving on, yeah, let's address this mission. This seems to be kill everybody mission anyway. I mean, the game is just structured like that, considering all the missions that I've played thus far anyway. Mission: penetrate the defenses at the drug lord's pillar, designated objective Storm, and capture him. Okay, capture him. Now that is interesting. I wonder, like, we can't shoot him. Okay, fine. I can see 4 allies. Your insertion point is 450 meters east of objective Storm. From this position, proceed through your checkpoints to the drug lord's villa. You are authorized to neutralize any mercenary perimeter patrols. However, your primary mission is to secure the compound and capture the drug lord alive. Why do I feel like that might pose a problem? So basically, I'm taking the longer route while my friends are, you know, going to be flanking the drug lord, sort of, you know, taking him from the back, so to be exact. Once the villa has been secured and the drug lord has been apprehended, Black Widow will extract you from the courtyard. Like Natasha Romanoff? This mission will only be a success once all resistance at the villa is neutralized and you have captured the drug lord alive. So it's basically eliminate everybody but the drug lord. I see. Expected enemy forces. All source intelligence indicates the remaining mercenary army has grouped at the objective. So, a lot. Okay. Got it. GA2 estimates this force as being approximately 20 to 30 men strong. My god. Al-13 will be inserted 500 meters west of the villa and proceed to a position from which they will secure your ingress route. That is nice. They will hold this position and provide suppressive fire during the assault on the compound. Charlie team will be inserted 500 meters northwest of the compound. So basically, wait, what? I'm supposed to be closer? Yeah, 450 meters, but that seems so far, and Charlie team is one of these, and that's like super close to the objective. Anyway, Charlie team will be inserted 500 meters northwest of the compound. They will ascend the hills north of the villa and eliminate any mercenary snipers within the hills. Now, this sounds like a well-planned out mission, to be honest, you know. One team handles the snipers, the other, you know, suppresses and distracts the enemy while, you know, the final team. I think it's supposed to be 3 or 4 members, but then again, I mean, I guess this game is taking artistic liberties here, you know, 3 squads, but oh well. I guess Delta Force either doesn't work that way or, you know, that's just how this game goes. But, yeah, mercenary snipers within the hills. Yeah, that's what they'll be eliminating, all the mercenary snipers. So yeah, while the Bravo team, that is me alone, since I'm a team on my own, go in and, you know, eliminate everybody and secure the hostile. Now, I mean, they should be paying me more, you know, because I'm literally doing the work of 4 people all alone. So yeah, they should be paying me the salary of 4 people. Anyway, situation. The acquired codebook contained the exact location of the drug lord's villa. Now I wonder why, you know, the drug lord keeps such sensitive information in a codebook which he's distributing to everybody, which literally has the decryption key to his encrypted messages. Anyhow, with this information plus final approvals from the Joint Special Operations Command, just JSOC, not JSF SOC or JCF SOC. I forgot what that acronym was. But the authorization for the capture of the drug lord has been issued. No wonder. And I will be taking full on assault here. Yep, exactly what I wanted to take. Double load ammo. Okay, I wanted to take double load ammo with me, but if this game is recommending that I take laws, maybe I shall take them. And I do not want a suppressed pistol at all. I would rather have the 45 caliber, because I hope this does more damage than, you know, effective range 50 meters. if it's range 50 meters, but I hope this one does more damage than the pistol. Just excuse me. Yeah, you guys didn't hear that because I sort of, you know, switched the mic off, but I'm having a sore throat, so I'm having to cough from time to time. Apologies if any of it makes it into the video. Although I do try to, you know, edit it all out.
King 6 is Black Widow. Alpha's in the LZ, Charlie's on his way to his LZ.
Black Widow, Black Widow. Come in, Black Widow, you sound a little off. Do you have a hoarse throat, perhaps, like me? Over, Joe Gatry. So, I actually fell in love with military simulation games when
Alpha Bravo, in position. Waiting for your signal.
Okay. Do not shoot the target. He must be taken alive. Fine. And...
Charlie, in position. We'll move on your signal.
And I can see two people right here. Anybody else? None that I can see thus far. Over here at least. Well, I heard somebody on my right, but yeah, thus far I can't see anybody, so I'm just gonna let it be. I'm just gonna let them handle that, you know, on their own. There should be some people over here as well. But yeah, so like I was saying, I fell in love with military simulation games when I played... I hope these guys don't come from, you know, up on top of the hills. Anyway, that should be Charlie Team's, you know, job to take care of them, but I don't know how effective they are at their jobs. Really? Is that the guy? No, I do not think it is. Oh yeah, that's him. 6 bullets to the nuts, my god. Wait, is that? Nah. I thought that was smoke for a second. Like somebody popped smoke. Did you just say me prego? Like, he's pregnant or something? Where's this other guy? I mean, we do need to take out all the hostiles in the area anyway. So, might as well start with this guy. Like, all the people here. Did somebody just say what? Like, could you not hear all the firing? All the shooting? My god. Get a grip on yourself, man. I see there's somebody over there. So, another thing that you'll notice about this game is that... the friendly forces fire, that's blue in color, the traces are blue. And enemy forces, they've got red traces. And that's something that that's like a nifty little detail that I always adored about this game. So enemies on this part of the map have been taken care of. I really hope I don't have to come back and take care of the stragglers down there, you know, on the underside of the map. And nah, that's still not the guy that I'm, you know. Oh yeah, there he is. Or is he? I mean, I can just barely see him. But not exactly. I haven't bothered with him. I just hope I don't have to come back and, you know, take care of them again. At a later point in time, I mean. The perimeter guards, they aren't really doing anything. But we did have to kill everybody, didn't we? So I guess I'll just go ahead and try to do that. Well, you're dead. And where are you guys? Over here? Now, this is something that I did not actually want to do. Like, turn on the map to, you know, display all hostiles. But I was forced to do that in the last mission because it was impossible to tell where the shots are coming from. I mean, one, it was night. And from whatever I've checked, I did not seem to find any... you know, a brightness setting for this game. So, yeah. That was a waste of a lot of shots. What are you doing, Charlie? You're supposed to be taking care of these guys. Why am I doing that? And where are these guys? Should be somewhere right about here. Maybe, like... Like around 150 meters this way, somewhere over here. Maybe in this crater right here. Behind this feature. Oh no, I can see one of them right there. Well, somebody is shooting them, so I suppose that's our friendly forces. I mean, I suppose those are our friendly forces. Sorry, I pressed the wrong button there. I actually wanted to, you know, approach this villa and see where all the enemies are. I can hear some law. Like some law, the law being laid down. No, that is Charlie too. And they seem to be doing a mighty fine job at this point.
Charlie 2 is down!
Oh my god. Like, how do you manage to do that? That guy did like a really amazing roll. Like a tuck and roll. But unfortunately, he died in the end, so... Okay, I need to take a breather here. Just lie down and try to ascertain who's shooting me at this point. That guy said.
Alpha 2 is hit! I repeat, Alpha 2 is hit!
What are you guys doing? Like, seriously? Like, can you guys be any more sloppy? You're dead. And my pals took care of some of the people there. So, Alpha team has been wiped out. It's just Charlie team. No, wait. Oh, so, okay, so it's just one person from each team, I see. Oh, I think that is the guy that we need to capture. Wait, what? What just happened? Just a second. Yeah. So apparently there's a resolution hotkey, which I did not intend to press. And I do suppose this is the guy that we need to capture. So... But except for the fact that there are still some enemies around here. And how do I take care of you, sir? Well, that takes care of that, I suppose. That is Alpha 1. He is prone inside the hill there. And are there any more people that I need to be worried about? It says that there are a few over there, so I'm just going to use a grenade launcher. And try and kill them. Okay. A little higher there. That should be the end of them.
What's the status? This is Alpha. Perimeter secure.
Okay, so we didn't even have to go...
Roger, Alpha. Target has been captured. Prepare for debriefing.
So apparently we didn't have to even go and capture this guy. This was actually a pretty simple mission, very straightforward mission. And I guess that's partly because of how the odds were stacked in our favor, the way they're supposed to be when you're conducting an operation. But yeah, I mean, it was a pretty simple mission. We didn't even have to kill this guy, like, go and capture him or anything. We just had to, like, not kill him and just kill everybody else, which is sort of strange. Sort of strange then, when you think about it. I wonder what will happen.
King 6 is Black Widow. Alpha's in the LZ. Charlie's on his way to his LZ.
Okay. Yeah, I'll just send the mission, and I will not be getting the, you know, kill count statistic, but... Yeah, the mission will be counted as over, so that is good. I don't know how many people I've killed in this mission, but it was pretty easy, pretty straightforward. Congratulations, Bravo team. The capture of the drug lord and the destruction of his private army has eliminated major source of drug production and distribution. Drug lord's arrest and trial will serve as an example to any other person who might wish to obstruct international drug enforcement laws. Obstruct them, huh? Well, I don't exactly think it's obstruction when you're actively working against it, but this seems to have brought us to the end of the Peru campaign. And yeah, that's all there was in the campaign, like 6 missions, so we're 2 missions short. So maybe the 2 of the other campaigns will be, I don't know, like 10 missions long, like 9 missions long, or maybe one campaign will be 10 missions long, who knows. Anyway, so on to chat. Now, we need to, you know, like, enter Chad right now, which is, I think it's a place in Africa, if I'm not wrong. Uzbekistan is in Europe. This is probably somewhere in the Arctic Circle, but I'm not sure. Indonesia is of course in Asia, so... Chad. Rescued hostages being held in the terrorist camp designated Objective Tremor. Now I wonder if even this mission boils down to literally just taking everybody out, because the previous mission it was literally a walk in the park, and yeah, the enemies were trying to flank me, but their weapons aren't really effective. Like, they're pretty much as effective as my SMG at close at those ranges, at longer ranges, like any range of upwards of, you know, 150 or 200 meters. So yeah, scaling is one thing this game didn't exactly have, you know, back down, but I mean, given the fact that this was one of the earliest games ever in this category, I would, you know, cut it like quite a great amount of slack. I'm actually at this point, I'm treating it more as a classic than a, you know, a proper game series. More like more playing this for the sake of, you know, understanding a classic video game at this point. But not to say that I'm not enjoying it, I am enjoying it, but yeah. Anyway, that's the end of the Peru campaign. Yeah, and we will come back for Chad. We will be tackling the first mission in Chad, which is a hostage rescue mission, and we'll be clearing the Exodus level. And until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.